What could possibly be so valuable on the moon that you'd pay $50 million to go there? Hey guys, Emily here for D News. During the Apollo days, it cost about 10 billion current day dollars to send astronauts on a round trip flight to the moon. Back then, we made the trip for things like national pride, to prove that our missiles were bigger than Russia's, and of course, not because it was easy, but because it was hard. Today, we have a new space race to the moon. There are officially 5 teams left in the $30 million Google Lunar X Prize. This is an international competition to see which private company can reach the moon first, move 500 meters across its surface, and transmit high-definition video and images back to Earth. But the really exciting part is what happens after the competition. With resources like water ice and helium-3, the moon is ripe for mining with a potential value of hundreds of trillions of dollars. Based on information gathered from orbiting satellites, NASA estimates that there's over 600 metric tons of water ice located in craters on the North Pole of the moon. This may not seem that exciting. Water is not that rare or expensive, right? Until you realize that water can be converted into rocket fuel, something that is crazy expensive. This means we could effectively create a gas station on the moon. Water, H2O, can be broken down into hydrogen and oxygen, which can then be converted into rocket fuel. Many of our rockets today use liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen to power their engines, including our old friend the space shuttle. In fact, this type of rocket fuel is the most fuel efficient of any known chemical rocket propellant. If we were able to do this on the moon, then anyone who wanted to send a spacecraft on a particularly long journey would stop at this lunar gas station and pay you to refuel before continuing on their journey into deep space. We all know how wealthy and powerful the oil and gas companies are here on Earth. Imagine if you had a monopoly on rocket fuel in the entire solar system. But there's more than just water. Helium-3 is a special isotope of helium that's rare here on Earth, but abundant on the moon. This is appealing because helium-3 could be used to create clean nuclear energy via nuclear fusion, without all of the radioactive byproducts that result from traditional nuclear fission. Yay! The downside is that scientists haven't quite worked out all the kinks of nuclear fusion just yet. But theoretically, if they did, and someone could extract all of the helium-3 from the lunar soil, there would be enough to power the entire Earth for thousands of years. Yeah. So maybe it's no wonder why companies like Moon Express, the only US company left in the competition, has been able to secure a total of $45 million in private investment, fully funding their first flight to the moon. In fact, the most unique aspect of the competition is that, unlike the Apollo days, this race to the moon isn't government-sponsored. XPRIZE requires 90% of any funding to come from private sources. The goal of that requirement? To encourage profit-driven business plans based on lunar activities. After all, what venture capitalist would invest in a company with no promise of a financial return? The challenge is, going to the moon is incredibly expensive and very difficult. It's no wonder why only 3 groups in history, the government superpowers of the United States, the Soviet Union, and China, have successfully soft-landed on the moon. In other words, landed without crashing. This means that whoever places first in the XPRIZE competition won't simply win a grand prize, but they'll be the first private company and the 4th entity in history to soft-land on the moon. Sure, they'll need many more flights dedicated to prospecting and perfecting their lunar mining skills, but if there's a chance that they could become the go-to gas station in the entire solar system or solve the planet's energy needs, it may just be all worth it in the end. So if one of these companies finds an easier way to get to the moon, could people actually live up there? We talk about whether or not you could create a livable atmosphere on the moon in this video here. What do you think? Who's going to be the next person to make it to the moon? Comment down below, subscribe, and come back for more D News every day.